Hello, I'm Venerable Nivato from Bodhinyana, Great Southern. Such an awesome experience to have this opportunity to be here. So today, let's have some fun practicing metta meditation together. Metta is a Pali word meaning loving kindness. What are the benefits of meditation? Well, to access peace, and with that, energy and joy, so that we are inspired to do great things in this life. Well, metta means loving kindness, and it's a quality, an intention, an emotion, a state of mind, one where we feel loving kindness, or kindness for short, a warmth, a softness, connection, joy, expansiveness. It's a quality that liberates. It's a quality that opens the heart. So today we've got the chance to practice meditation together. Dhamma teachers are very valuable in this world because they pass on the teachings of the Buddha on how to reduce suffering, to understand it, and even to transcend it. As a result, we also have the opportunity to respect and dedicate merits to our Dhamma teachers, especially and including Ajahn Brahm, who has been a monk for over 40 years. And all these years, he's given so much service to humanity and to other beings as well through his encouragement to make peace, be kind, and be gentle, and through his instructions on meditation. This is a worldwide coordinated metta meditation program to celebrate Ajahn Brahm's 70th birthday. The Buddha said, hatred never ceases by hatred. Hatred only ceases by loving kindness. Ajahn Brahm has a famous quote, the door of my heart is always open to you, no matter who you are, no matter what you do. That's unconditional love, the high expression of love one can give another. Rumi, a poet, wrote the following. Crumble, be ground. Let the wildflowers grow. For too long, you have been stony. So today, let's soften this heart. Let's make it crumble. Let it nourish. Provide the environment for peace, kindness, and gentleness. And spread the emotion of loving kindness to others, to ourselves, and to all living beings. So let go of everything. And let's together enjoy our time together, this hour together, this precious hour together, and do something good. And then dedicate the merits to our Dhamma teachers, especially Ajahn Brahm. So find a comfortable position where you're comfortable and upright at the same time. Well, actually, let me rephrase that. Comfortable, yet alert. Not upright, don't have to be upright. Comfortable, but alert. Close your eyes. Think of a cute animal, preferably one you know, maybe a pet, a fluffy kitten, or an adorable dog. Hug this animal. Feel the connection, the warmth. See the joy on the animal's expression. Feel the quality in your heart, your mind, that feeling of softness, of connection, of joy, of warmth. That is loving kindness. Smile. By smiling, we send a signal to the brain to let go and just calm down, telling the brain that we're no longer running away from danger. That we're not fighting anymore. So let go, surrender. Think of a kind person, maybe a grandparent, or a friend, a true friend. Give them a hug, or at the very least, shake their hand. Feel the connection, that warmth, the softness, the joy in your heart, your mind, and see their beaming smile as you hug them. Feel the emotion of loving kindness in your heart from this experience. That is loving kindness. With this emotion, find a way to enlarge it, to expand it, to make it as big as you can. Magnify this emotion of loving kindness in your heart, in your mind. Smile. Smile gently. Now, to access that metta, the loving kindness when you need it, to trigger it, just picture the cute animal or the kind person once more, or both. And once you've tapped into the emotion of loving kindness, once you have that feeling in your heart, your mind, think of a loved one and send direct loving kindness to that person. Say the following and mean it. May you be happy. Say it and mean it. All beings seek happiness, but a lot of the times we only find and experience suffering. We all share something common, in that we all seek happiness. So let's wish ourselves and others happiness. When we are happy from a very wholesome activity, such as meditation, especially loving kindness meditation, we naturally want to share, to spread the emotion of loving kindness to others. By sharing, we increase the joy. Through giving, through dana, we create much joy in our heart and our mind, especially if we do so regularly. So our good deed from practicing meditation together today, we will dedicate and share the merit with our Dhamma teachers, our spiritual friends, and especially Ajahn Brahm. Now, picture that adorable animal once more, give it a hug, or hug that kind person. And once you feel the motion of loving kindness in your heart, in your mind, wish yourself happiness. Send yourself metta. Because we ourselves deserve loving kindness. May I be happy. Say it and mean it. We need to love ourselves first before we can truly love and serve another. So let's heal this injured heart first. Don't forget to smile. Now, think of a person you irritate with. Tap into the emotion of loving kindness. Once you have the feeling, direct metta towards this person you're irritated with. May you be happy. Say it and mean it. Summon up the emotion of loving kindness. Once you feel the emotion, expand upon it. And now, let's direct metta to all living beings. May all living beings be happy. Say it and mean it. Now we have about 25 minutes left. So in this time, I will be silent. So use this time to go through tapping into the emotion of loving kindness first by picturing the cute animal and then the kind person. And once you have the emotion of loving kindness, make it larger. And then when you're ready, in your own time, send loving kindness to first a loved one. And then direct loving kindness to yourself. And once you're ready, direct loving kindness to a person you irritate with. And finally, send metta to all living beings. And remember, this is a group meditation, a world coordinate program, where you've got other meditators who have the same aim. So let's use their support, the support of one another, to uplift one another in our practice of meditation today. Let's fill the space around us with loving kindness, and then send that loving kindness to beings around us, and even to the whole world, to all living beings. Let's soften this heart. Let's nourish and nurture this heart. Let's make it crumble. Let's feel the connection, the warmth, the joy. And don't forget, let's have fun together. So I'll see you in 25 minutes time. Please enjoy the experience. I'll be silent now for 25 minutes. I'll be silent for 25 minutes. Feel the peace in your heart right now. The gentleness, the softness, the warmth, the joy, the connection. Let's direct loving kindness to all Dhamma teachers and to our spiritual friends, and especially to Ajahn Brahm. May these beings be happy. Picture Ajahn Brahm's face, his smiling face. A face that expresses the emotion of loving kindness, of care. No matter what you do, no matter who you are, the door of my heart is always open to you. Direct metta to Ajahn Brahm. Smile. May we share the merits from our practice of meditation together today to all Dhamma teachers, to our spiritual friends, and to Ajahn Brahm. We wish Ajahn Brahm a long, healthy life, so that Ajahn can continue to enrich and touch and inspire so many people, as well as other beings. So now that you know how to access metta in your heart, your mind, if someone makes you angry, you now have the tool, the loving kindness at your disposal to forgive. Because remember what our teacher, the Buddha, said, the antidote, the cure, the medicine for anger, for hatred, for ill will is loving kindness. So direct loving kindness towards the person you're angry with. Once, twice, three times, over a week, 2 weeks, a month, and you're likely to find that after a period there'll be no more anger towards that person, no more resentment. May all beings be well, happy, and at peace. Feel the connection, the warmth, the joy in your heart right now. This is the emotion of loving kindness. Practice loving kindness every day for your benefit and for the benefit of all beings. Metam ca sarvalokasmin manasam bhavaye parimanam udang adoja chiriyancha asambadang awerang asapatang titan charang isino wa sayano wa ya vata savikatamido etang satinga diteya brahma metang viarang idam ahu Titin janupagama sila vata sanena sampano Kame suvineya gedang Nai jatuka baseyang punae titi. Spreading loving kindness towards the entire world, spreading upwards to the skies and downwards to the depths, outwards and unbounded, freed from hatred and ill will, whether standing or walking, seated or lying down, free from drowsiness. One should sustain this recollection. This is said to be the sublime abiding. By not holding to any views, the pure-hearted one, having clarity, vision, being free from all sense desires, is not born again into this world. make peace, be kind, be gentle. It's been a pleasure spending time with all of you.